everybody, my name is Sophie Walker and I'm here today with Golfalot at Denton Golf Club trying out the Titleist TSi metal fairway woods. I've got the TSi 2 and the TSi 3. I've been fitted by Titleist and now I have the TSi fairway woods in my hand, ready to take them out onto the golf course. Now, if you're new to this channel, please click the like, the subscribe button and ring that bell. And comment below, we want to hear from you. Now, the TSi 2 fairway wood was the one that I got fitted for. Surprise element, I don't know if it's my ability or the golf club's ability, it's the best striking I've had off really tight mats in a long, long time. I really struggle with three woods. It's not the club for me. I struggle to find one that I hit well off a tight lie, and you can't get any tighter than a mat. And either head performed really well. I didn't feel like I had to pick it up. I didn't hit many out the bottom. They were just really good, consistent strikes every time. Interestingly, coming into the fairway fitting, I thought I'd be the TSi 3 because that's what I like from the driver. But I ended up with the 2. Now, thinking about it, that's logical because I've always said I struggle to flight my 3 wood to get it up in the air. Now, the TSi 2 is a slightly higher launch. So don't think, oh, I'll be the 3 in the driver, I'll be the 3 in the fairway wood. Be a touch more open-minded. Looking down on them, there was very little difference, but performance-wise, that bit of higher launch really helped me. So I'm going to compare the 2 and the 3 off the fairway, not off a mat. Second shot on the first hole at Denton, it's a par 5, it's a long one, so I'll be needing a good 3 wood. Nice, now for the TSi 3. Now the TSi 2 was a high flight. We're going to see if the TSi 3 produces anything different. Visually, I thought it was less spinny and slightly lower. Now, both of these shots went, what, the same distance, 6 inches different, but the flight was different. And that's what you've got to decide. What type of ball flight do you want? Now, I would like a higher 3-wood ball flight at the moment because my bad shots are out the bottom of the club. And be it in winter, I think I need the carry right now. A lot of the courses that you'd play maybe on tour, they were all carry golf courses. If you're playing links golf or you play on a very firm golf course, you don't have to carry the ball onto the greens, you can chase them up, the TSi 3 might be for you. But I like that bit of flight, that height, even on my bad ones. So not a lot of difference in distance, just difference in how high that they went. And I would say the TSi carried slightly further and I got a few more yards chase on the TSi 3. Now, this is something you won't see a lot on YouTube. A 3-wood into a par 3. So welcome to my world. Slightly uphill, 190 yards, and I've got to hit 3-wood. So I'm going to start with the TSi 3, which should be good into the wind, shouldn't it? Because it does go a touch lower. Slightly toed, you can just see it there. Just got on the front of the green. Let's have a go with the TSi 2. Now for the TSi 2. Yeah, noticeably higher into the wind. It's really stalled on me. That's something to think about. Uphill into the wind, TSi 3 definitely performs better off the tee. Talking about the heads, first of all, both got the arc technology to aid strikes off the bottom of the golf club, which is the most predominant spot. Most of us will hit 3-woods if we catch them poorly. And then the weighting. So TSi 2 has a fixed weight at the back to get the high launch and that's adjustability. However, this is pretty cool on the TSi 3. It's the sure fit, center of gravity, and you can move it, okay? So, see that's in the toe at the moment. You can move it along to neutral or out the heel. So that's where you predominantly would strike your shots if you're someone that finds a similar type of the face all the time. So I'm going to put mine back to the toe. But what's cool is there's nothing hanging off this golf club, right? It all fits really nice and compactly. You can see that there. So turf interaction will be loads better than anything hanging off, and it doesn't get as dirty, which is always a bonus in my opinion. So right, I'm now going to hit the TSi 2 and change the settings from the most extreme high draw to the most extreme low fade. So I'm going to put this in A3 right now. So I've added 1.5 degrees of loft, which is noticeable looking down on it, and it's become slightly more offset for a more pronounced draw. Now I hit draws anyway, so look out for left. Just finding the left side of that green. Go slightly higher. I'm getting more used to seeing these clubs going high, but that's a bit too high from me, and a touch to the left. So let's change the setting to the lowest loft and fade. I've moved it into C1, so I've taken a touch of loft off it and it's not as offset. The difference actually is noticeable with the two extremes, that's for sure, to the naked eye. Let's see how it performs. Oh yeah, a lot lower ball flight. I didn't find it went as much left, but actually I always try and hit my free woods a bit left to try and get a bit more flight out of them. But in terms of height, very noticeable. For me, not so much on the left, but you know, I've only hit a couple. But I think the versatility and the adjustability of these are fantastic. You can see it to the naked eye and you can see it in the performance of the ball. I'm now going to cover shafts and price. Now a featured shaft TSi Fairway Wood is 279. That is what I got fitted into. But if you want to go premium, which is, you know, the orange shaft that Jordan Spieth is using, that is £449. Now the shaft is why it's expensive, okay? There's no difference in the head. Yes, it's a hell of a lot of money, you know, £450 for a fairway wood, but you're paying for the shaft. The good news is I got fitted and I was fitted into a featured shaft, so that did bring the price down. However, it's a lot of money, but the word premium says it all. My verdicts on the TSi Fairway Woods. I think the majority of us will be in the TSi 2 because we're hitting out the bottom. We want a touch higher launch. The likes of Wiesberger, Ian Poulter, they're gaming that. So you can be TSi 3 and a driver, but I think a lot of us will be TSi 2. Adjustability, excellent. The way the heads look is great. I notice a great difference between the TSi 2 and 3 in the driver, but in the fairway woods, not so much. Slightly deeper face in the TSi 2, elongated like back of the head. I quite like that though for a 3 wood because I want to launch it in the air. I struggle with that. So let's hit one to finish. Thank you for watching my video on the Titleist TSi Fairway Woods. If you'd like to read the written review, check out golfalot.com. Please click that subscribe button, the like button, and comment below on this video. We want to hear from you. Will you be trying these fairway woods out or not? Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you again soon.